Does your body feel sore after you sit all day?
Of course!、Mm. 在坐了一整天之后，哎，你们的身体是不是跟 Laura 一样，常常会感觉到很酸痛吗？
Don't worry, I feel sore sometimes too.、Mm. Now, what is sore? Well, it is our word power word, and it's spelled S-O-R-E, sore.Sore is an adjective, and it is the feeling you get after you exercise and use your muscles too much. So the next day, your muscles might feel kind of tired, and it's very hard for you to move around, and you might feel a slight pain. So maybe after using your phone for a long period of time, your eyes might feel sore, they feel tired. So if your eyes are sore and they feel tired, you need to put your phone down and rest your eyes. Let's take a look at our sample sentence for today. It says, Joanna's eyeswere sore from trying to read in the dark. Joanna's eyes were sore from trying to read in the dark.
Oh my god, I'm so sore all over. 谢谢，我真的很希望你帮我按摩。Sore 呢，就是酸痛的，像是如果你有肌肉酸痛，如果你去 exercise, 你就一定会有 sore muscles, OK? 它是个形容词的 sore。所以呢，像是哎，如果你的背痛，你就可能会说 my back felt sore， 或者是如果你跌倒的话呢，你可能会怎么样 ？After I fell, I was sore, or there's this other word, achy, a c h y， 就是疼痛的 all over。那有时候腿很痛，你可能就会说、I have a sore leg。不过大家应该更熟悉，就是我们感冒的时候喉咙痛，哎，也是会用到 sore 这个字，就是 a sore throat。那回到刚刚 Tiffany 提到的例句啦，就是 Joanna's eyes were sore from trying to read in the dark. 真的，如果你试着跟 Joanna 一样在黑暗中阅读，你的眼睛一定会怎么样？很酸，很痛。
Mm-hmm. All right. So next, the article says, if so, you might be sitting the wrong way. So, like Laura, maybe you didn't sit really properly, so that's why your muscles are sore.
Mm-hmm.所以你常如果感觉到酸痛的话，如果是这样的话，你的坐姿可能是错误的哦。
Mm-hmm. Well, don't worry. Here are some tips for sitting correctly at a desk.
Okay, I'm listening. 我一定要学这个东西哦。所以以下提供你一些正确坐在桌前的一些小 tips.
Mm-hmm. So whether you're a student or whether you're working, there's a lot of ways to sit properly at your desk. Now, here we see another word power word, desk. It's spelled D-E-S-K.Desk. A desk is a noun and it is a table you use to do your work on. So you might have an office desk if you work at an office, or you have a school desk at school and this is where you do all of your work. Let's take a look at our sample sentence. It says, I have a desk, a chair, and a bed in my room. I have a desk, a chair, and a bed in my room.
我们来看一下 desk， 相信这个字大家都不陌生吧，就是桌子啊，书桌，它是个名词哦。像是如果你是在工作的时候呢，你可能会在这个 office desk 工作，就是办公桌。哎，不过在学校我们看到的这个教室里面的桌子，当然就是 school desk。那 desk 常常后面我们可以接一个名词，像是 a desk lamp， 就是这个书桌上的这个小台灯啦，或是 a desk calendar， 没错，就是我们常会放在桌子上的一个日历啊，或是行事历。OK， 那看回刚刚的例句，提到就是，哎 ，I have a desk, a chair, and a bed in my room。我的房间有一张桌子啦，然后一张椅子，还有一张床啦。
Mm-hmm. All right, so what are some ways for us to sit properly? Mm-hmm. Well, first of all, the first advice is to put your feet on the floor.
Oh, that sounds easy. So, 第一个呢，我们要怎么样？把脚放在地面上。Okay, 我来试试看。
Right, so we should put both our feet on the floor. And it says, your body weight should be the same on both sides. So on both of your feet, your weight should be the same on the both sides.
Okay, 我现在在调整我的坐姿。
It's kind of weird at first, right?
对，你的身体的两侧的重量应该要平均哦。
Mm-hmm. That's right. So what is weight? Well, weight is our word power word, and it's spelled W-E-I-G-H-T. Weight.Weight here is a noun, and it's basically the amount that something or someone weighs. So how heavy this person is or how heavy something is. For example, we can use it in a sentence like this. The weight of this big box is 100 pounds. The weight of this big box is 100 pounds.
Weight 呢就是重量，它是个名词哦。Mm-hmm. 所以如果要问对方的体重，就说 What's your weight or how much do you weigh? W-E-I-G-H 这个 weight 就是它的动词，就是有多重。But it's super rude to ask somebody's weight. Okay, 问体重很没有礼貌。不过可能在一般，如果你去医院的时候，你可能要填一个可能跟健康相关的表格，大家可能就要知道你的身高啦、体重。Mm-hmm. 那体重我们已经知道是 weight， 身高顺便。来学一下就是 height H-E-I-G-H-T 那如果你要增重的话呢像我想要 gain weight OK 那减重的话呢
I want to lose weight
对就是 lose weight OK 那刚刚的例句提到就是这个大箱子它的重量它的 weight 是100磅 100 pounds、
mm-hmm. So maybe I can give some of my weight to you And then、Please. We will be perfect So I can lose some weight and you can gain
know,
a little bit of
I
weight
I want that
So it's perfect Alright, so what more should we do? It says Try not to cross your legs Now when you cross your legs It means that you put one leg over the other Just like what Laura is doing Now, often ladies do this We cross our legs because it looks more ladylike It looks more polite So you shouldn't cross your legs when you're sitting down Because that means the weight of one leg is different from the other And it might cause you to feel even more uncomfortable
Especially when you're wearing like a mini skirt 其实这样也很容易曝光好不好
You can actually tuck your leg underneath your foot That's another trick that you can learn
OK, 可能拍照可以啦、但是平常在做的时候不要怎么样不要翘脚 OK, 当我们用 cross somebody's legs 就是可能翘二郎腿啦或是翘脚哦 OK, 所以尽量不要这样子因为这样你的 weight 你的重量就会不平均你可能就会加重在另外一个脚上咯
That's right Alright, so the second tip OK, let's move on It says keep right angles, okay? Now what does that mean? Keep right angles. Let's first take a look at the word angle. It's basically the shape that forms when two lines meet each other. So in math, in geometry, we learn about 90 degree angles or 45 degree angles. And angles is basically what the shape that happens when two lines meet each other.
Okay, 所以第二个我们告诉的大家就是要保持正确的角度，那我们还不知道什么是所谓的正确的角度。不过其中的 angle 我们知道就是角度的意思啦。那注意不要把 angle angel 傻傻分不清楚，很多人把这两个字都拼错。因为我有朋友的名字叫做 angel， A N G E L 也有天使的意思，可是不知道为什么大家都会写 dear angel， 就写给他就变成角度啦。所以不要把这两个字，而且它发音也完全不同哦。
Angel and angle， All right， so just be careful with the spelling. The end spelling I know is a little bit confusing. All right, so what kind of angle should we keep? The article says your hips. So here, your knees and feet should be at an angle of 90 degrees.
Okay, 这有点数学了。所以你的臀部，然后还有膝盖，或是这个关节 ，OK， 膝关节，还有这个脚，就是脚腕，应该是要保持90度，所以要长这个样子啦。
That's right. So it should look like this. This is your knee. So for facing, you should look like that.
Right.
All right. So let's take a look at another word pair where we see the word knee. It's spelled K-N-E-E, knee. Knee is a noun, and it is the part of your leg where it bends. So with your knees, you're able to sit down, you're able to jump. Okay, that's where the knee is. Now we have a really fun saying. If you're weak at the knees for something, this phrase just means something that makes you feel really dizzy or faint. So for example, seeing blood makes me weak at the knees. Okay, this thing doesn't make me feel very comfortable. Next, let's take a look at our sample sentence. It says, Bobby can't play basketball today because he hurt his knee. Bobby can't play basketball today because he hurt his knee.
Knee 就是膝盖啦，那注意哦，它的拼字虽然它有个 K， but the K is silent， K 是不发音的哦，所以直接用 knee。OK， 那像是如果可能你跌倒的话，很容易膝盖就会受伤。I fell down and hurt my knee。
Ouch。
那刚刚 Tiffany 提到这个 weak at the knees， 我觉得还蛮有趣哦。通常呢，就是可能是看到或是谈到非常喜欢的人，或是让你害怕的事情，就会让你怎么样膝盖发软啊，或是腿发软。像是如果想到 到啊，我如果要跟彭于晏拍接吻戏，The thought of kissing him made me go weak at the knees，我腿就会发软，因为太害羞了。OK， 那另外通常求婚的时候，我们可能会怎么样？单脚跪下来求婚，所以就一个膝盖在地上，所以我们会用什么呢 ？Go down on one knee and propose，propose 就是求婚啦。好啦，那刚刚提到的就是这个例句 ，Bobby 呢，他今天不能打篮球，因为他的怎么样 ？He hurt his knee， 他的膝盖受伤了。
All right, so next, let's take a look at our third advice. It says, remember the curve in your back. So remember, our back, we have a curve. Now, a curve is basically just like a round shape, okay? Oh. So we have a round shape, like for example, in your lower back, you have a curve right here. Yeah. And on your back, on the upper back, you have a curve as well. You can think about it in baseball, pitchers, they have to throw different kinds of balls. And one of them is a curved ball. That means the ball is thrown in a way where it kind of almost goes in a round shape.
OK, 所以你要记住你背的曲线哦。曲线我们就用 curve 这个字哦。像是在棒球有一个东西叫 a curve ball, 曲球就是变化球的一种。那身材呢，如果我们说有个人他身材是 curvy,OK,、okay, C-U-R-V-Y, 就是他的曲线是玲珑的。OK, 所以不像东方人都很瘦就没有那么好看，要有曲线才好看啦。
Right, alright, so next it says, keep your lower back round, do not strain your back. So you don't have to sit very, very straight, so the lower back is like, you know, very round or very curved. You should keep your lower back round, so don't strain your back. So again, round is like, a round shape is something shaped like a circle, and we're just having that kind of, that curved surface. Now, when you strain something, it means you kind of injure your body part by using too much of it, or using too much tension, using too much effort. So you might strain your back if you use too much of your back muscles.
Oh, maybe I did that, right?
Probably.
That's why. Okay, 所以将下背部保持是弧形的，因为 round 有除了圆形的意思，还有弧形这样的意思，所以不要去拉伤它。其中的 strain 就是拉伤的意思，它是个动词哦。
It's important to sit with good posture. So we kept saying posture, posture. Posture is basically the way your body is when you sit or stand. So a good posture means that you should be in a position where your body is, you know, not straining your muscles and you kind of have your shoulders back and you stand up straight and tall.
真的耶，其实有良好的坐姿，就是 posture, 就是姿势，真的很重要。因为其实像站的时候，我觉得还是要 stand up straight, 也是要挺胸。像我就是站跟坐，我都没有 good posture, 惨了。I have to learn.
It's alright. It takes a while because maybe I'm short, so I care about standing tall. That's why.
And I'm like so tall, so I don't care about standing the right way. 好了，有利有弊哦。OK, 那最后。我们看到是什么呢?
It says, if you don't, you might hurt or strain your body, right? If you don't have a good posture, maybe you might hurt yourself in the end.
真的,要不然你可能就会伤害啦,或者是劳损你的身体哦。Okay, that comes to the end of today's article, but first we have to check out our magic box.